Cool. Let's see here. Let's do a quick recap of last session, and then we will be on the road here. So I'm gonna start you guys out. You're already at the main page. Good. All right.
Yep.
You guys arrived in Phandalin, and Halia Thornton told you that both Talos and Miracle were already operating in town. You went there to deliver some goats, but you know, things suddenly got more serious. Also, Halia recently became a were-rat, you noticed, and is going to join her were-rat brethren in the mine. You later found out that she kind of had a thing for were-rats. She wanted to be one. She was kind of almost like a fangirl. And, was totally into getting turned. And the were-rats have otherwise been totally respectful of the town of Phandalin, not turning anybody that didn't want to be.
Mm-hmm.
You heard about some new people in town and quickly discovered that they were, the agents working for Miracle and Talos. Valene Firecrow, a red-haired elf woman who has a pack of kobolds. She was working for Lenine Greywind over at the Lion Shield Coster. Turns out they're all cultists of Talos. And they also learned about Argus Skeel, who turned out to be a vampire working for Mirkul. He did mention to Jin that you guys have been interfering with Mirkul's plans for a lot longer than you realize by defeating the white dragon Cryovane. You don't exactly know what they're up to or what their intentions were, but kind of an interesting thing to hold on to. You ended up in a three-way battle, which ended up with you guys winning handily and Valene Firecrow escaping as the only survivor. She did get in a few good sneak attack hits for fleeing, and then you had to hunt down your remaining ghoul.
I'm pretty sure the ground got better hits than she did.
Yeah. Argus Skeel, Bell, you noticed this about Argus Skeel, that his clothes had the same kind of seeds and barbed, those little briars and things like that. And you recognize them because they're the same ones that are on your armor, because you both had been to the Mare of Dead Men. So you get the impression that the cult of Mirkul is operating in that area. Yeah, maybe even headquartered in that area. And though you did not find Valene Firecrow, you did find her pack. She set it down before the fight. It had a case within it, and within those case were lenses. And this interesting trinket was accompanied by a note in common that says, "The lenses reveal the secrets of the map."
Yes.
So you guys finish off the session by getting the supplies Breltora Red Eye requested, and you also had a Dabra volunteer to join you. It was kind of something that everybody was thinking anyways. And you left your sending stone with Toblin Stonehill of Stonehill Inn so that he could contact you in case Phandalin needs its heroes again.
Yes.
That was last session.
And we also did we just did a quick jump where we went up to the
Shrine of Sharrows
and got the shrine thing.
Mm. Yeah. Empowered his amulet or something.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Also, yes. Yes. You went to the Shrine of Savrus and performed a quick ritual to imbue the amulet that Galio Librio had given you, in hopes that you could use it on the in maybe right. Being able to find your dragonborn friend, black dragonborn friend. So that's how we start this session. You begin it along the Tribor Trail. Let's go ahead and look at the map here.
We never did also, we also never checked out that big X on the end of the you know, this X. Is that some lighthouse or something?
Yeah, yeah, that was just a lighthouse thing.
is that a just a lighthouse as in don't go check that out, or is that, oh, that's just a lighthouse?
That, you know, you don't know until you know, and you don't know what you don't know.
Sure.
Okay, so we need to go check it out. Yeah. We know.
So, for the moment,
For the moment, we're there. Really, you up here.
Yeah. For the moment, you have left Phandalin, and you just turned onto the Tribor Trail. And as you begin to travel along the Tribor Trail with your friend Adabra and the supplies meant for Leyland, it's a beautiful day. There's a light breeze, a clear sky. You can't help but dwell on your adventure and your adventure's past. The first time you came along this road and you heard your first dragon, seeing the white dragon Cryovane flying overhead. Another time you're traveling on this road, you were heading north to Dragon Barrel. Ended up in the Underdark and meeting Hammerbell. And finally, you know, traveling along this road, leaving toward Leyland, victorious after defeating that white dragon. You know, the all great memories, all difficult challenges, but the real threats, it seems, remain in place, and they're much beyond the power of that young white dragon. As you kind of discuss and contemplate, to the west, in the direction of that wayside inn, storm clouds are gathering.
Sure.
Towards light.
Very strange, very, very strange storm clouds in the shape of three swirling lightning bolts.
Oh, no.
It's enough reminiscing. You got to get back to work.
Well, at least they make it, you know, at least
obvious what the next quest counter is.
Yeah. Quest great. So
yeah, it's a really cool quest marker. Giant lightning bolts in the sky.
Do we think we can make it to the Wayside Inn before we run into terrible weather?
Well, you either way, you continue on the path because you can't tell quite just yet where the center is. You know, it could be out here at the X, even.
Sure.
Could be at the wayside, could be over here somewhere, you know, you don't know.
Sure. So my thought, let's go ahead and leave the wagon, get the wayside in if possible, and we can leave the wagons and stuff like that there, and the people, and then we continue on to see what's going on. Because they could be doing like another summoning for Water Race, whatever it was. Like, we need to kind of.
That sounds reasonable.
Yeah, how far is it? To the water. It's beyond Wayside Inn, right?
Yeah, it's still quite a ways.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's another. What was one of these? One of these.
This says it's 15.
One hex miles. Is 5 miles. One hex is 5 miles. So, yeah, 15 miles.
So you basically added in quest markers, but not quick travel. What the fuck?
Yes. Uh-huh. So there you are. There you are. You're about halfway between the turn from Phandalin and the Wayside Inn. And you travel a little bit closer because you're not sure where the best spot is going to be to ditch the wagon if you need to. And you do indeed see that those storm clouds are just getting bigger. They're getting darker, and they seem to be centered on the Wayside Inn.
Oh, great!
Oh no,
that's handy.
Well, yeah. I mean, let's double time it there. Are we gonna get there? I mean, is this a leave early morning, get there at night type of thing?
You guys left in pretty good time. So we're going to say it would normally be a bright and sunny afternoon at the moment.
Well, I mean, that's the direction we have to go, right?
So if it's near the wayside end, I don't particularly want to leave the wagon there. We could take Webley's horse and the monk and double time it on our own, pretty much. Want to take some horses or whatnot and get there before the wagons. Of course, we'll have to leave Webley with the wagons because someone has to protect him.
Not
a terrible idea.
It's a thunderstorm. I mean, we know it's an evil thunderstorm, but you know, I mean, I don't know what's our options other than continuing quickly.
Like the wagons are going to slow us down, I think.
So right, you, while you're discussing, you see a couple of shadowy figures coming out, and you know it's almost like the dark clouds are just, they continue to spread, and you see these figures in the distance coming towards you. It doesn't take long for you to realize that they're not fighters. They look miserable as they are soaking wet, and they're coming towards you. They've got a wagon. It's got spots for two horses, but there's only one horse pulling pulling a large cart. They're just completely wet, and all the stuff in their wagon is gone. One of the only, the singular caravan guard sees you guys and trots up, you know, just kind of half jog as he's sloshing in his boots. And he says that they got within a mile of the inn, and the weather became so violent that they couldn't continue. The driving rain, the fierce winds, hailstones the size of apples, impeded progress to an absolute crawl. And then one of the horses was struck by lightning and killed. And
oh, Jesus.
And this is when you realize that this haggardly looking caravan guard is actually Anders. Of Anders and Thistle. Two of the teenage kids that, you know, worked at Phandalin. You realize it was probably a pretty big deal for the two of them to get out of town and maybe, you know, he says the caravan was headed for Neverwinter, so it'd have been the first time that you'd know that these boys have ever, you know, been to the big city.
Go the way to or the way back?
They were headed to. They had to turn back.
Okay.
What happened to your buddy, Thistle?
He said, Thistle, he decided to stay back just to check out how bad things would get and to you know, he's a brave, stupid fool. I told him to come with us, but he wanted to stay back and keep an eye on things.
I don't know. Do we have these guys camp out here and go in on foot? Do we have any magical means of weather protection? Anyone? No?
Oh, what kind? Like, I have protection from energy and stuff like that. Well, I don't think I really have anything from, like rain.
I don't know. There's no, you know, Otto's big umbrella. I don't want all of our shit to get, you know, washed away, right? That's part of the deal. So do we need to leave it here?
Probably best to leave it behind. Unless the storm comes toward us.
All right, I ask Anders, if we go check this out, we need a place, we need to make sure our stuff is safe. If we set up a camp here, will you keep watch of things until we come back?
All right, give us
24 hours, and if we're not back, stuff is yours.
Well, no, I mean, like, Webley is with him, right? So.
Yeah, yeah, Webley's going to volunteer to stay back.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Oh, I feel so much better already.
We're going to be light. We're going to be light a spellcaster? Okay. then sure. If Webley's staying there.
Mm-hmm. So I like the idea.
I like Billy's idea of just leaving shit and going in, you know.
Best all right. Can. So mm-hmm. Webley and Anders are going to basically combine the wagons and you know, make one big caravan. Mm-hmm. They will retreat as far as the juncture, the T-juncture there, in order to stay away from the storms. And of course, you know, Anders, you know that he's probably okay with weapons, but he's not going to be able to protect them. Hmm. Adabra goes ahead and, you know, starts crafting up some potions or whatever to maybe keep them from getting sick. And so she goes with Webley and Anders as the caravan starts moving back, and you guys look forward towards the wayside.
Getting soaked.
I want to like pat Anders on the shoulder, saying he's doing a good job with those. Or if he's putting that equipment to good use. A little bit of encouragement for him.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, now do you really have to look for trouble here?
What kind of adventurer are you? Besides the one that's still alive. That's a good argument. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah. So here we are. You guys are going to keep going down the road, right?
Yep.
Yes.
I do, however, steal Webley's horse.
There is no rain underground. Nice. I mean, you know.
That's so true.
Yeah. So, Belly isn't
ooh,
very
look
happy.
Look at the animation. Sweet.
Yeah.
That's fancy.
I need nice to buy that animation pack.
I just have one very important question. Is it dim lighting?
Under the storm clouds?
Yeah, I mean, what time? I mean, is it generally dim early evening? Basically, can I teleport or not?
No. It is. So over here on your side, it is a nice sunny day.
Okay.
And underneath the storm clouds, it is a little bit darker, but I wouldn't quite call it dim.
Okay.
It's definitely. It's a shade.
Great.
All right. As a wall of storms surges and howls in the distance, the sunny, mild weather gives way immediately to rain and hail, violent winds, and electrical discharges. Passing in and out of that wall, where you guys see, you know, the edge of the storm is, are three figures in plate armor, each swinging a flail at a lone figure in splint armor, wielding a longsword. Azure, give me a perception check with advantage.
For me or my bird?
For you.
Okay.
Yep, that's good. You recognize your work. This must be Thistle.
Ah.
So for Bell, I don't think you were there for that. Before the party picked you up, these two were basically the you know, Barney. What was Barney's name from?
Barney Fife.
Yeah, Barney Fife. These two were basically the Barney Fifes of Phandalin. You know, trying to. just two young punk kids trying to protect the town, you know. Five. How do I not remember Barney Five?
So the lone fighter attacking him.
Yes, he is trying to run away from the storms, and they have kind of spread out and cornered him, or are blocking his path here.
They look humanoid.
They are.
Oh.
They look like three suits of armor. Now, you guys might remember that the last time that you were at the Wayside Inn, you met an armor named Tiga. And Tiga was really proud of her three sets of plate armor that she had forged. And I think maybe Azure was the only one who saw this, because he was the only one kind of interested at the time. But Azure, you recognize the lightning bolts on this armor as the ones that Tiga showed you, and she was so proud of.
Great. Well, we don't want him killing Thistle.
All right. So. Let's get it going.
One second.
At least I don't have to worry about Doc trying to get his character in 20 times.
I'm gonna roll again and see if it's any higher. Nope, take the 11.
All right, let's see here.
Yeah, give him about the 11.
Oh, the 11?
Mm. Kind of hard to do, like, advantage.
Yeah.
Azure, Jen, Fairvax, Bell. And we got the Owl and Mox. All right. Wait, sort by descending. Actually,
is it possibility to taunt them out of the storm?
That is something you're going to have to find out. All right. Let's see. So this guy is going to move in. On that third strike, you see Thistle. You know, he's taking these two just wild hits from this flail, and on the third strike, he's able to roll away and even make a little bit of distance between him and the enemies there. This guy, he's, you know, pulling his flail up out of a rock or something. Fairvax.
So he managed to get past him?
Yep.
Okay. Let's see here. Yeah, we're gonna do that. Okay, so range. I am going to move. Move up. and I'm going to drop a flaming sphere right there.
All right. Said right here?
Yep. Now, I think I can use a bonus action right now to move.
Yeah, if you haven't used your bonus action yet.
Okay. In which case, I can have it run into this guy to do damage.
Okay. And that is a... what, dex DC save? 14?
Yep.
DC 14, dex save. 30, 14, damage is 10. Half on save?
Yes.
All right.
Oh, and you need to add the 3 points for Radiant Soul.
All right. Your little flaming sphere finally, you know, it's almost distracting how such a thing can exist when, you know, the rain is just pouring and pounding down. But still does. All right. Anything else from you?
Nope. That's all I can do at the moment.
All right.
Well, I did Hooter. Not. Oh. So, it's pretty violent winds up there, so I doubt Al can actually fly up there, correct?
Yeah, you get the impression he's going to have some trouble.
Okay. So basically, I'm going to have him just fly over here. Keep an eye out.
All right. As for yourself?
Forward and throw out a spiritual weapon. Out there. Here we go. Boom. Pretty sure I have enough. Oh, 60. 1 second, so.
Oh, wait. Forgot to do this as the flaming sphere. That way Thor has control of it.
Thank you.
All right. There. Our spiritual weapon there and attack this guy right here.
All right. Go ahead and make an attack. That is a miss.
And I still have my actual regular action. I'm going to go ahead and essentially dash since I move again. There. That is my turn.
All right. Bell.
Bell will move forward. I think she can get this far. And try a hand at the crossbow and see if she could get that one.
Oh, this guy right here? All right, go ahead.
Oh, forget it. Yeah. She tried. And she
had the rage. Okay.
She sucked so bad at the crossbow, it made her really mad.
Yeah,
it
got really mad, yes.
Yeah. Probably is pretty frustrating. Mm-hmm. All right. So in response to not having, you know, having a crossbow bolt just limply land in the grass next to him. This guy's gonna move forward. He's gonna see if he can attack this dude. Thistle.
Thistle's gonna die.
Ouch. That was a total of, like, 24?
Yeah. Thistle's like a fifth level fighter.
Yeah. Yeah, Thistle is now unconscious.
Sweet.
With that first flail strike, just caught him in the back of the head. And then he just started wailing on him as he fell to the ground. So Thistle does not look well. Jin.
I should. I'll move up a little bit. And try to put a couple arrows into that guy.
This one right here?
The one that's got the flip that's been, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Flaming spear guy. Let's see. Oh, actually, what's my range here? Hold on a sec. Where's Mark? Uh, 90 feet. Okay. Yeah, I'll Hunter's Mark in first. And then take a couple of shots.
Okay. That is a miss.
And I'm going to use my... And now, just... Oops, sorry. Ignore that. Click the wrong thing. Here's short bow. 18.
That is a hit.
All right. Damage is... 9 points.
All right.
And that's what I got.
Let's see. Oh, wait. That short bow, is that magical?
Nope. Does it look like it does anything?
It does.
The Hunter's Mark is magical.
Right.
I assume, so.
Yeah.
3 points to that. I don't know, maybe it isn't magical.
I would assume Hunter's Mark is magical. For those purposes.
Okay.
All right. So it definitely looks like your Hunter's Mark does a lot of the, you know, a lot of the damage. The arrow itself seems to scrape across and does some damage, but just, you know, you might even say he was resistant to it, you know.
Sure. Yeah, one would think. Yeah.
For lack of better terms. All right. So this guy is going to come to the edge of the storm here.
Oh, he didn't step out of the storm? I mean, just, I'm just, that's cool. Okay, good. Good to know.
Yeah, he's going to step all the way to the edge of the storm here. And... attack. Azure. Yeah, that's a mess.
Ouch.
Ouch.
So if I pop Geo, doesn't make a difference because it's a crit, right?
It's not going to make any difference in this case, because your normal AC is what, 22?
Yep.
So that would mean that he still meets the AC.
Gotcha. Okay.
So you take 6 plus 3 bludgeoning, and then an extra 18 lightning damage.
Okay. On that case, as a reaction, absorb elements. drop in chat. It's a reaction.
Yeah, so you take half that lightning.
So, 9 and 9 then?
Oh, that's kind of neat.
Yeah, it's a good
spot. All right, so yeah, so 9 lightning, 9 bludgeoning. And, see here, there's something else about these.
Con save.
Nope. Not concentration. Well,
no, con save because of the... Oh, so keep from being stunned.
Oh, right, yeah.
Oh, there it is.
DC 13 con save.
Okay. I blame a con save for my spells. Like, nope, I got that one covered.
Ouch. All right, so you are stunned, and as you see Azure become stunned, he is he also gets this mark resembling 3 parallel lightning bolts across the front of his forehead.
Uh-oh.
That can't be good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now, when you're stunned, does that drop concentration on any other spells?
Stun will drop concentration, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, it does.
I don't have any spells up to take concentration.
That's good. Yeah. So if you had the blunder up, that would be an issue, but the spiritual weapon doesn't have that drawback.
Yep.
Cool.
All right. So how many attacks was that? That was 2. At least the third one with advantage. And you take another 9 bludgeoning. I'm going to mark this guy because he can't use that lightning thing again for a couple of turns. All right, Mox.
Okay, she's going to go over that way. And ready in action for when I need her to swoop in to deliver a touch spell.
All right. Now, before we do this.
He's going to move the whole thing. All the storm moves in. Okay.
All right, the storm continues to push outward and expand. And you notice that these guys really just like stay on the edge of that. So this guy is there. Oh, he can hover. All right, he's going to use his action to dash all the way this way. Fairbax.
Okay, bonus action to move the flaming spear to hit this guy.
All right. Got a dex save DC.
It's not letting me move it. What is going on?
Dooby. There
we go.
I get it.
I like that one. It's bigger.
Yeah. More fire is always better.
Take that one down in size. You could control this one?
Yeah. I just dragged it from the tray.
Oh, okay. All right.
So that seems to work. All right. Let me roll damage.
Right, I can go ahead and let's see. Dex save, DC 14. Damage is 15.
18 with plus, +3.
Yeah, +3. Ouch. Ooh. All right, he takes full damage from that.
Okay. And I'll use my regular action to hit this guy with a pair of Eldritch Blasts.
All right, go ahead.
And that's a mess. That roll.
And that is also a miss. Right. What will the owl do?
Continue just to watch.
What will the cleric do?
Stay in there just in sheer utter stun. I'm stunned to the end of his turn.
Yeah, he's stunned to the end of the guy's turn.
Oh, okay, yeah, till the end of his next turn. Okay. Belle
will move and attack this one, which is going to be reckless.
Sweet.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
All right, that's a hit. That is not. And that is not.
19.
Okay. Bell comes in, gets him with the axe, misses with the hammer. These things are fast and also pretty beefy. This guy
She's
is going to move in.
Madder.
And just to make sure I'm playing this fair, when somebody is stunned, you have advantage on attacks against them, right?
Yep.
Okay. That's a miss. Jesus, come on. All right. Well, he came in and somehow managed to just he's beaten the crap out of Azure with his flail, but it's just bouncing off the armor and the shield and everything else, you know. He's got a hard head too. Jin.
Yeah, I'll do better hitting them. I'll run up there and beat on this guy.
This one?
The one that's, yeah, directly southwest of me.
Okay. It's a hit.
Two.
Not.
And three.
That is not. So the first one hits.
Fortunate. All right. He can roll a con save. 9 points. That is magical. And a DC 13 con save or stun. If they can be stunned.
Is it a stun or a paralyze?
It's a stun.
Okay. No, sorry, you didn't get advantage, but we'll go with the first one.
Cool, that's what I got.
All right. Applied damage to him. All right, now it's his turn. He's pretty interested in you, Jen. since you kicked him in the face there.
Great. Yeah, that's all gonna hit.
Ouch.
Wow. Pretty hard hitting.
29.
That is 29.
And was this 3? Oh, no. And what's my electrical damage?
Oh, no, nothing. Oh. So that's like a one-off he can choose to do when he hits, but it has a cooldown. Okay. And he already used his.
All right. So no con save or anything like that?
Nope.
Just 29 points. Oh,
yep. Okay.
Yeah, so just half my hit points. Cool. All right.
Yeah, you know, that's all. Just 29.
Wrong. Yeah.
Webley.
All right.
And we really need like a cleric to heal or something. Nah. Cleric smash.
That's what you got a Sorlock for. Mox, what are you up to?
How difficult would it be to fly into the storm?
You would have to. It would be a little bit difficult. You would have to make. There would be a saving throw involved.
Okay.
What were you thinking?
Well, would her magic resistance protect against it at all? Given that it's probably a magical storm? At least give her an advantage?
What magical resistance? Let's see. Character sheets. Spells and other magical effects. All right. Okay. I would give you advantage on that roll.
Okay. Because what I think I want to do is I want Mox to get close to Thistle. Because that way I can basically try dropping a spell on him. And if we can revive him and get him up and fighting, he might be able to lend a hand.
All right.
Or at least not make death saves.
Right.
Oh yeah, I've been making his death saves.
So let's let's get him stabilized, is what I'm thinking. So the idea would be for her to get over here.
Sure.
All right. So you want him to fly in there. Give me a, let's see. It's going to be a strength saving throw.
Ooh, that's going to be rough.
I mean, just thinking like, you know, trying to fly against the winds and all that stuff. Oh, but you passed. All right.
Yay.
And what do you cast?
I don't have anything that I can use right this instant because I used my bonus action and everything. I just wanted to get her into position for it.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Because it's one of those, if it was going to be something where you know, she'd have to actually run along the ground, it would take her longer to get there. And wanted her at least be moving in that direction already.
Got it. All right. This guy is going to come down. See how he does.
Yep.
Jeez.
Yep.
And all right, so that is 10 bludgeoning, 10 plus 1 bludgeoning, and a crap ton of lightning damage. Make that constitution saving throw.
It's not gonna matter. I don't think I can soak that. I can't. I have absorb elements, so I only take 9, 21, and 9. Yeah, it doesn't matter. I'm down.
All right. Give me the check anyways, just to see if you end up with the lightning bolts on your forehead.
Oh, okay. The con?
Yep.
Con save. I think.
All right. So as Jin is knocked unconscious, she has these same three lightning bolts parallel go on her forehead.
Sweet.
And let me mark him as having used that. Fairvax.
Okay, I'm going to use Healing Light as a bonus action. Three dice of healing on Jin.
Nice. Those are D6s, right?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's pretty good.
And I'm going to do a level 3 Cure Wounds on Thistle.
Okay. All right, Thistle is, he kind of brings himself up to a sit and looks and sees you guys in trouble. And he's just, immediately jumps to his feet. I'm going to have him. Oh, I guess I have to actually assign him a... No, not a Choldrus.
If it's good, can we?
I'm not overly concerned when I have a raging barbarian right in the middle of things, but
still. You have too much confidence in her.
You're taking half damage and you're doing a fuckload of damage, so
she can still get zapped. But yeah.
All right. Anything else, Fairvex?
I can't do anything with just my reaction at this point, so I'm...
And this guy should take damage on the start of his turn, correct?
I think it's if he ends his turn adjacent to it, he'll take damage.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it'd be nice if it was at the start, but I think it's at the end. Okay. With the way that it's written.
Well, I mean, if he decides to move, he's got to take a lot of opportunity attacks.
Yeah.
Azure.
Okay, so the bird's not going to do anything. Hooters isn't going to do anything. Hooters or Hoot Hoot? What'd you call it earlier?
Hoot Hoot.
Hoot Hoot. My bad.
I said Hooter. Is this a girl owl or a boy owl?
It's an arcane construct.
Nice. Well, they are called Hooter.
Okay. The bird's just going to move up a little bit and just kind of watch for now.
All right. And as for yourself?
Oh, I've been wanting to do this for a long fucking time. Oh, sorry. Heat metal.
Isn't he still stunned?
No. No. He's finally up.
Yep. He's back. So you're going to heat metal on this guy.
Yep. So he takes 2d on his armor.
Yeah, which he can't really take off.
Exactly. And so he takes 2d8 damage. And he has disadvantage on attack rolls and ability checks until the start of the next turn.
Well, what's that save for?
To drop the weapon if you can. Drop the item.
Yeah,
you can't drop it.
Doesn't matter. Alright, so not even going to roll for the save. Just take the 10 damage and disadvantage on what now?
Attack rolls and ability checks until the start of the next
attack
turn.
Attack rolls and ability checks. Nice. What a...
As a bonus action, I'm going to move my hammer up and smack this guy right here back of the head.
Alright.
Does not.
Yep. Does not.
Then I'm going to action surge and dodge action.
Ooh. Fighter. Hammerbell.
She will continue her assault on this.
All three of those hit. 11 plus 9 is 20 plus 18 38. You smack this thing with the hammer, spins it around a little bit, you know, as it's kind of floating in, you know, in the air. Smack it with the hammer, spins it around a little bit. You actually catch your great axe in the armor. You know, you pierce through the armor, make this big old slice in it with your great axe, and all these like stormy, you know, kind of electrical stormy looking clouds kind of pour out of it as the thing starts to, you know, just looks you in the eye and looks really worried. Then you just bear hug it. You just grab you take your hammer, you put it on the other side of the armor and bring it in to your spikes. And, yeah, this thing is not looking good at all. He's looking almost on the brink of death here.
Dang. Come on, Thistle.
All right. Thistle's gonna run up here. And get his, character sheet up. We got here. Let's see, he has a great sword. Sure. Goliath's giving him advantage.
Because I made the sword. That damn good.
Sure.
Good answer. Oh, and it
never whisper rolls. Don't auto. All right. All right, so he rolled a 9, and let's see. That second one hits. He gets in 10 slashing on this guy. The armor's floating a little bit closer to the ground. It's just really, really beat up. This one is going to try and attack Hammerbell, seeing what's been done here. And he gets advantage, right?
Yep.
Give me that con save.
Con save.
Ooh, you passed the con save.
Can she All right. dodge any of those?
No.
I mean, you're taking half of the damage here.
Yeah, sure.
But does that include lightning?
Not lightning. No,
only.
All right, so you take 18 lightning damage, and that's 23 plus 6 is 29. So you're taking 19 plus 18, 37 damage total.
Wait, no, not 19.
The no, 29 half would be
29 half be 14.
Oh, 15, right. 14. Yeah, 14.
So,
yeah,
32?
14 plus 18. Yeah, 32. You're fine. I'm going to be the one dropping again.
Some math for Marines there. All right. And even though she got hit with that lightning strike, you do notice that there are not three lightning bolts that appear on Hammerbell's forehead. Jin.
Do I still have lightning bolts on my forehead?
You absolutely do. They look like they're burned in.
Oh, that's just upsetting. I'll take half my movement to stand up. I'll swing at the guy north of me. And 13 points, and he can make a con check for stun. DC 13.
Let's see. Con. Ooh.
Sweet.
So he is stunned.
Stunned till the end of my next round. I'm going to hit the guy to the south that's looking very bad, to the southwest.
Yep.
Just in case I have to run.
That's a hit.
Hold on a sec. The first guy, add back those. Take off the. He gets back 4, and the hunter's mark is not there. Sorry.
Oh, right. Yeah, the hunter's mark is here.
First guy gets back 4. Second guy only takes 9.
All right. So you run up to him. You put your foot on the bottom of the armor, and you almost do this like flying back flip. Kicky thing, and you kick the helmet straight off.
All right, so I'll bonus attack the guy to the north, and that should be an advantage since he's now stunned. Do-do-do. Bink.
That is
another 6 points to that dude. And since he's stunned, I'll hang in there.
Alrighty. Mox
is gonna retreat back to where it's easier to move.
Give me another strength save with advantage.
Yep.
All right, that's good. And anything else?
That's pretty much it for what she's doing right now.
This guy is stunned, so he can't do crap. Fairvex.
All right. Let's see. Yeah, bonus action, move this thing here. And hit him with it. Guarantee that he's going to take damage.
I think when you're stunned, you automatically fail dex saves. Good. Just go ahead and roll damage.
Okay. So that'll be 16 damage. And then we'll blast him twice more with Eldritch Blast.
All right.
Ah, come on. Actually hit him.
When he's stunned,
you get advantage.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Okay, hold on. Right,
so we'll count those two as you know, 2 9s. Roll me a second one with advantage. That one does hit.
Okay. Stun force.
Right. Anything else?
Nope, that's all I can do right now.
Owl's not doing Hooter. Anything. Just keep an eye out.
Right. Forgot to do this since it's a new round.
Oh. I don't want to have lightning bolts inscribed in my forehead.
Neither do I. Wait, does a headband do anything for Bale?
You don't have them.
Yeah, especially if they're glowing lightning bolts, that'll make hiding difficult.
Yeah.
They don't glow. They don't glow, but they do. They are kind of a Harry Potter scar kind of deal. You know, just a
I'm
scar in your forehead.
Down somebody cast a regen spell on me.
Okay, so first off, scars. He's taking damage from the heat metal. Ah. But he still, since he took damage, he still has disadvantage.
Does he take damage on your turn?
As a bonus action.
Ah, yeah, that's right. Okay. Alright, so he... taking heat metal damage. What else?
I'm gonna smack him with my... Dwarven Thrower.
Alright. Nice, that's a hit.
Add another two to that for the dueling.
Boom.
And that's my turn.
All right, Belle.
Belle will attack this one.
All right, give us the... Okay, so first one misses, second and third one hit. 16 plus 11, 27. All right. You are just chipping away at this thing. He's pretty beefy.
Still standing though.
Thistle is... Where's a stupid character sheet? Does a whole 9 slashing. Now it's his turn. And he's not really worried about Thistle behind him. He's gonna make one flail attack at Thistle.
Disadvantage.
Remind me again why?
Heat armor.
Oh yeah, that's right. Okay. So there's his disadvantage. He hits Thistle good. Doesn't quite take him out, but then he turns towards Hammerbell. He did try to put lightning bolts on you last time, so I'm going to mark him. Turns towards actually Azure.
Disadvantage.
Ugh. All right, there's a disadvantage, 22.
Okay, it matches my armor class, so I'll just spike it with shield.
And then that one misses as well. All right. So that's all he can do. Hit Thistle and then get frustrated against Azure. Jin.
All right, here's the attacks on this.
1 second, I gotta yell at my kids.
You're still stunned. One, two. Those are all very poor. Whoosh, whoosh,
whoosh. None of those hit.
I am going to run away. A goodly amount.
Good point. I mean, good.
All right. And then yeah. Since it's the end of your turn, he is no longer stunned. All right, Mox.
Mox is going to stay where she is right now.
All right. This guy, having no longer been, since he's no longer stunned, is going to move down. And he's going to make his attacks against Hammerbell. Now, Hammerbell, are you still reckless?
Yes.
Sweet. What? What? Does a 17 hit you, Bill?
Oh, yes.
All right, so you do take 4 bludgeoning damage.
Hey, guy, I want to point out something real quick. Every time you did that lightning strike, the damage didn't change. It's not rolling damage.
Well, lightning strike.
The DM's, the ability that they're doing?
Oh, yeah, it's not rolling damage. He's just pulling the average damage.
I'll say,
it says there is 3. Oh. It's not rolling.
4 times 3 is only 12. It's not even average damage.
It's 4 times 8.
Oh, 4, 8?
48. Okay, yeah, it's 48 bad. Lightning damage.
Okay.
Yeah, it just says
it's been 18 every time. I said it hasn't been rolling it.
Yeah, no. He's just taking
48.
Yeah.
I thought maybe it was a, let's see. Yeah, it is not rolling. I thought maybe it just happened to.
No, it happened every time. When it happened the third time, it's like, wait up, hold up.
Yeah. All right. So you don't take any of that lightning damage, by the way. You do take 4 bludgeoning damage. And on that third swing, he goes wide and you're able to rush in and hit him with your spike. So go ahead and roll me some spike damage, Hammerbell.
Do I get advantage on that?
Oh, you
hit. Yeah. 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 I'm saying that you hit him. All right. So that's 9. All right. Took 9 damage on his own turn.
Woohoo.
Fairvex. Oh, wait. Since we're waiting on Fairvex.
I'm going to hit him with the Flaming Sphere.
Oh, right. Okay. So that is a Dex save. DC 14. That's how much damage? Is that 14 damage?
14.
Right? Could you add +3?
Yeah.
14. Save on half. Did it not do it?
Appears to be thinking about it.
I'm just going to roll him a dex save.
There you go.
There, he failed. Now I will apply that damage. I don't know why that macro suddenly stopped working.
Yeah, no idea. And then I'm going to actually hit him with an Eldritch Blast this time.
Oh, you think so, huh?
Yeah, no.
Oh, no. All right, so you did hit him with 1. You did hit him with 1. And he will take the 7 force damage. Go ahead and roll damage on that first one, though, that crit fail.
What's that? Okay.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
I'm not standing close.
No!
This will fall over.
Great.
And he will be making death saves. All right, Azure. Your owl.
The owl. I'm going to do the, as a bonus action, go ahead and do the heat metal again.
Oh, so the owl's not doing anything?
No, owl's not doing anything.
All right. All right, heat metal. That is 15.
13, not dueling, sorry.
Oh, right.
Still up and kicking?
Yeah. Yeah, he's starting to look really rough, though.
Booming blade. Try to hit him. 24 to hit.
You must make a melee attack. Okay, so 24 to hit.
Damage.
Okay,
is...
so normal effects. So give me a...
Here you go.
Okay. Oh, and you did thunder damage to him?
Yep. Part of Booming Blade. At higher levels.
13 plus 4. That thunder damage doesn't appear to do a whole lot to him, but you know, it's still damage. Damage is damage. But
and if he moves somehow, he's kind of SOL. So, and that'd be my turn.
All right, Bell.
Bell would switch target to this one.
All right. That's a hit. That's a hit. That's a hit.
That's gonna hurt.
It's 18. 36. 44.
Probably overdid that one, didn't I?
No.
No.
You have put so many holes in this thing that you're curious. You're surprised that it hasn't fallen over yet.
Oh, no.
But it's just barely hanging on. Would you like to move or anything?
Nah.
All right. Brave. Okay. Anders, Thistle, groans in pain on the ground over there.
Great. Sorry.
All right, this guy, he's going to go ahead and continue his assault. And
disadvantage.
All right, yeah. Let me go ahead and click disadvantage. He's going to go ahead and continue his assault on the cleric. Are you casting shield?
Sure.
Right.
It's only a first level spell.
Then he just slams that flail against that magical shield, which is really just emanating from your actual shield, you know, from your holy symbol that you had emblazoned on the face of the shield, and he is just trying his damnedest to get through it, but the might of Talos is not quite as strong.
Damn, Spray is not quite as strong as my Morden.
The mighty Moradin. Jin.
All right, an arrow on one that's on Hammerbell.
Don't hit me.
Oops, not advantage. Sorry, 16.
All right, 16 is a miss.
All right, another shot at the same dude.
And a 12 is a miss.
Okay, I'll sit there and click off arrows. That's all I got.
Mox?
Back over to Thistle.
All right, give me that save. Strength save. With advantage.
Yep, just a second.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, the wind is just too much. He has to tuck in his wings, actually strains one of his wings a little bit, and he lands on the ground right about here.
Oh.
Okay.
A little bit injured. Give me a D4.
That could kill him. How many hit points does he have?
All right, he takes 2 damage. And how much movement does he have left?
She has fly 60 or 15 on the ground.
All right, I'll let her finish the movement on the ground. You know, just kind of keeping her low crawling, you know, with the wings tucked back so it doesn't catch on the wind.
Okay.
Able to make it over there. Mox is last, right? Oh, Yeah, there it is. All right. This guy is going to flail with advantage at Hammerbell. Does that 16 hit?
Yes, all three hits.
Yep, 13. Any idea how many rounds this has been?
Four or five.
All right, makes sense. All right, that's all he's got. It's the end of his turn.
He takes damage from the flaming sphere.
How many saves or death fails does what's his face have? That should.
Okay. That's so he'll get 7 damage from the flaming sphere.
Is that half on save?
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter. He actually right after he finishes up with those hits, Hammerbell, he just kind of starts to, you know, catch on fire and falls over. That flaming sphere just melted him up. All right, Fairvex.
Okay, I'm going to cast Cure Wounds on Thistle. That's actually pretty good.
All right. Thistle,
Don't you auto-cast that at third level?
Well, I was using one of my sorcerer slots to cast it at one.
Okay, gotcha.
Because I already used both of my level 3 warlock slots.
Gotcha.
And then I'm going to... Let's see.
That's bonus action magic.
Yeah. And as a bonus action, I'm going to throw Healing Light at Jin again. Unless Hammerbell's looking really beaten up.
No. Just couldn't still. Maybe.
Yeah, and I hope this is taken the right way. Jin is definitely looking uglier than Hammerbell.
Yeah. Now I've got 3 lightning bolts in my head. That's the worst part about this fight. Not the almost dying.
Okay. All right. Owl.
I'll lend you the
owl is going to try flying out of the storm.
All right. Give me a strength check for the owl.
Ouch. I don't want to.
Oh, no.
How?
Oh, no. Give me a d4.
It's dead. It only has 1 hit point.
Oh, no.
I
don't want to go
there. If those are... Luckily, you can summon him again.
Yeah, it's a ritual. So, owl. I'm really pissed. I tried to kill my owl. First off, heat metal.
Heat metal,
for 12 damage.
Ooh. All right. As you're starting to see cracks in the armor from being overheated, you know, it looks like a... It looks like, you know, as a person who spends a lot of time at the forge, it looks like a piece of armor that has been overheated, and it starts to wear thin and just get really brittle. What else you got?
Booming blade. Five to hit.
Go ahead and give me some damage.
No. Go to there.
13.
All right. So right in the 3 lightning bolts upon the chest of the plate armor, you smite that symbol of Talos with your own of Moradin, and very mightily it falls.
Okay, can I do a couple actions out of combat, or what are we gonna do with this?
Need to get out of the storm.
Let's see. So the storm continues to expand. And Thistle says, oh, we've got to get out of this storm. Yeah, let's go ahead and get rid of the turn order here. Says we've got to get out of this storm, and you hear him, and he's got these, he doesn't have lightning bolts in his forehead, but he picks up Mox and just runs, and just starts running. So everybody kind of move out of the storm here.
Before I go, I'm gonna try to spell magic. On the mark.
On the storm?
Mark on my head.
Oh. Give me a religion check.
Okay.
Yeah, don't burn a third level unless you have to.
Oh, boy. You don't know a whole lot about these.
Well, it might not even be magical. Oh, it'd be magical. Fuck yeah, move out for now.
I guess I gave you a hint, but you know. All right, so once out of the storm, and you guys are able to just like walk and stay outside of the storm, Thistle tells you a couple of things. The stormy area is slowly growing larger. I had to retreat several hundred yards to remain outside the zone. I have no idea what's causing it, but it's such blatant and powerful forces of magic are nothing I want to be involved in, if I have a choice in the matter, that is. And, the lightning was everywhere, but it never struck the suits of armor, even though they were made of metal. It didn't make any sense. I was almost struck a few times myself, but I kept repeating prayers.
What prayers?
Okay, so
prayers, you know, to Talos.
I just kind of shake my head at him.
Look, I learned them from a woman. You're not friends with her.
What was the name of the woman from the wave, the armorsmith for Talos?
Oh, that was Tika.
It was Tika.
No, it was, I met her when I was working at the Lion Shield Costa. It was Valine Firecrow.
Oh, sweet, yeah, great.
And that's why I wanted to make it to the Wayside Inn. I think she came this way when she fled after the battle with you guys, and I wanted to see her again. I wanted to see her, but I don't know if she wants to see me, and I figured maybe if I tried hard enough, I could win her back.
Interesting.
So what do you know about this person?
He was thinking with his short sword.
practically nothing at all, but I'm a young man. I there's not a whole lot that I care about.
Sure.
Or need to know.
So the question is, continuing on, do we think we can, if we go, can we get a short rest in if we head away from the storm?
Yeah, you guys can definitely get a short rest in.
Okay, in that case, before the short rest, I'm going to do a second wind.
Okay. What's that do?
It's just
it's a fighter thing. He can regain hit points and then use a short rest, and then he regains use the second wind.
All right, because if we can do a short rest, then that means the warlock's back up, and I feel generally better. I mean, I've got all my key, and we can burn some hit dice.
Yeah, while you guys are resting, Thistle's telling you all this stuff, but you know, even though he's a little bit, you know, he knows you guys don't necessarily like the idea of him repeating prayers to Talos. He honestly does think that's the only thing that saved him from getting struck by lightning. And he said, are you planning on going through there? I mean, I could teach you one of the prayers.
I don't think our cleric's going to buy that.
Not at all.
Sure, I'm interested in it. Yeah. Teach me one of the prayers. I got fucking lightning bolts on my head. What's it matter?
So you saw him face like, so you think the prayers prevent you from being struck by lightning? We know that weapon armor served you well.
Yeah. He says, don't make me go back in the storm. Praise be to Moradin. Praise be.
There you go.
I'm gonna run back to the cart. Did you see Anders?
Yeah, what to say? I'll send him back to the wagon.
Jeez.
We're back.
Yeah. Well, yeah, he said cart, not car. And yeah. Back to my Hyundai.
I tell him, it's like, look, we met up with Anders. Your caravan, our caravan are merged right now. Webley's waiting for you. Go.
So he goes ahead and runs, and he does recite a prayer to Talos for you guys, so that anybody who cares can memorize it.
You just smite him. 1 second. There it is. Stun smite.
Okay, I've rolled horrific hit dice.
Damn,
what's going on with you, Jin?
This is great. Sweet.
Oh my god.
You are gonna crit next.
Oh, I got 2 left. Bink, bink. Well, after using all hit dice, I'm still down 3 points.
Oh my god.
So, yeah. Okay, but I've got full key. I'm ready to go.
All right. So, as you guys continue to short rest, I'm going to call a 5-minute break.
Okay.
And we will continue in 5 minutes. Let me
give me a little bit of music, please?
Change our music here.
5 ones on my hit dice.
All right, be back in 5.
All right.
Be back in a bit.
Alrighty. I don't think that was 5 minutes, but is everybody back?
I'm here.
Back.
I heard Jim and yep. I think Thor.
Yep.
So as far as tough combats go, that was pretty good.
Yes.
Given that it was only three opponents, that was pretty tough.
Yeah. Yeah, it was it's hard to challenge you guys without having like an hour long combat session. Or just giving everything like, you know, plus 12 to hit and 66 damage.
Well, I feel better with a 22 AC cleric that has a few shield spells.
Yeah, that was definitely clutch. I love this stormy effect.
Yeah.
All I did was take that, what was it, fog cloud. Put a fog cloud. Looks like this normally. I just made it bigger. You can extend it out this way. There, now it's a storm cloud.
Nice.
Okay, I'm back. During that short rest, I'm praying to Morden with some very choice words for Talos. Like, I'm not gonna fucking ready that pussy ass bitch to get me through this.
Sure.
I'm working that into my prayer to Morden.
Yeah, yeah. You notice as you do that, there's a storm cloud that forms over top of you. No, I'm just kidding.
I'm back, but I'll be on mute.
All right.
Azure, give me a religion check.
Fuck.
All right. You pray to Moradin, but even you know, you just don't. You feel the weariness in your words. And Fairvax, your situation is a little bit different. You're because you're not a cleric.
Yeah.
If he wishes right. to enlighten me,
help me understand what's going on with them.
Help you understand what's going on with what?
With those lightning bolts.
Oh, good question. Those lightning bolts, it turns out, are a curse.
Great.
And okay. So, without using some method of removing curses, they will probably remain there.
Like a remove curse spell or something.
You know, if there was a spell that specifically removed curses, I don't know what it would be called.
Curse, which it's a, I just don't have it prepared. I mean, I can go back to a long rest and prepare it.
Well, that may be necessary, but hopefully it isn't a particularly nasty one yet.
Yeah. Hopefully it's not a curse that keeps clerics from learning, from memorizing and remove curse. That'd be a nasty curse.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah. Alright, unless I'm tripping over myself, then I say we go forward.
Alright. So, here's the thing. I'm going to go ahead and line you guys up.
End of the storm.
I need... Are any of you going to be saying prayers to Talos as you go through the storm?
Not until I get hit by lightning, I'm not.
Okay. Everybody, roll me a d6.
I mean, I don't care if they want to do that. How did I roll? How did I say I rolled? Oh, that's...
Okay. Theravex, you got a 2. Azure, you got a 3. Jin, you got 5. And Bell, you got 6. Okay.
So here's a suggestion. Since we know that I'm cursed and the monk is cursed, I want to get through this as quickly as possible. I almost want the horse.
Well, sure.
I mean, you've got quite a bit of ways to make it to the Wayside Inn.
Because where this
is happening.
How many miles away?
Say again.
How many miles away are we?
Oh, you guys are like. I mean, it's probably only like 2 miles.
Fairfax flying is not going to be helpful
unless I can actually get above the storm. But chances are that thing's really high in the sky if it's a normal thundercloud structure. I mean, it's definitely not a normal thundercloud, but if it's structured like one.
Yeah, we don't have any way of really making people quick except for one horse.
Well, fuck it. You guys ready to go?
Sure.
I don't see any other choice if this thing keeps expanding. You know, that's going to be even more devastating, so we got to get through it and figure out how to stop it.
Yeah. Let's see how much damage we're taking along the way.
Alrighty. So nobody right now is saying any prayers to Talos.
No, I'm not.
It's okay. I don't understand if you guys are pussy out. Let's do this.
All right. So as you guys start running through, all of you, let's see. Da-da-da-da. All of you give me a DC 15 con save.
Con save. Oh,
fuck. Yeah. Everybody give me a con save. All right, Jin and Fairvax. Jin, you're able to... Jin, you actually roll with disadvantage. Sorry. And so do you, Azure.
Well, it doesn't matter. I didn't make it either time anyway.
So let's see, that is 6. All right, everybody who failed DC 15 takes 12 lightning damage. I think Fairvax is the only one that succeeded.
Great. How far have we traveled in this 12 damage amount?
So the way the module reads, I'm just going to go ahead and explain this part so we don't have to worry about split hairs on distance. The way the module reads is whatever you rolled on the D6, that's how many times lightning is going to strike you.
Oh, great.
as far as anything else, Oh, and you have disadvantage on the rolls. You have disadvantage on the saving throw if you have lightning on your forehead, which is Jan and Azure. All right. Let's see. Anybody saying prayers to Talos?
After I get hit once, sure, I'll start praying.
All right. Give me a religion check, Jin. With disadvantage.
It's okay. Disadvantage. Religion. Sweet.
All right. You fail it.
Okay.
All right. Anybody else?
Fuck you, Talos.
I guess Hammerbell's. Hammerbell's reciting stuff.
All right. Hammerbell. Let's see. Oh, because Hammerbell rolled 6.
Yeah.
She's like, yeah, to hell with this. All right, Bell. It doesn't appear that lightning comes down to strike you anymore. For everyone else, make that DC 15 con save.
At disadvantage.
Yeah.
At disadvantage for Jin and Azure.
So,
ouch.
Another decent. Nope.
How much? 15?
Take the damage.
Yeah.
I'm choking down my potion of greater healing. It's the only thing I have. Let's see. What is that?
Okay. Fairvex, you're no longer going to take any lightning strikes because you rolled a 2. You've taken your 2.
Okay. 44 plus 4.
How much damage for the most recent one? Oh, 15?
Yeah, 15.
4 plus okay. 4.
Great. 13 back.
All right. Azure and Jin with disadvantage. Give me another DC 15 con save.
Okay, I didn't take the first, I gotta take the minus 15 first. Okay, con save, disadvantage.
Sweet. I actually saved. Oh no, that was a dex save, sorry. No wonder it rolled so well. That's better.
Fuck. Ouch. Ouch to the both of you. Yeah, I'll be nice and just do 3d6 and not anything else.
As a reaction, absorb elements.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll burn a spell to absorb elements. Take half of that. That's my
okay.
Last spell. How many first levels do you have left? Was that it?
None. That was it.
All right. Azure, you're done taking lightning.
All right.
Jin, you got 2 again. More.
Great.
All right, give me that DC 15 con save.
DC 15. Oh, sorry. Disadvantage con save.
All right. And go ahead and give me one more. And I'll just roll 66.
Oh, hold on.
Why don't you roll 3d6? Because they might heal me.
Hold on. Hey, Jin, do you want me to burn the spell for you?
No.
Third level. I literally have protection from energy.
I'm doing okay. All right, here's the last one. Great. I'm down to 8.
All right. Let's see.
Oh, is Fairvax curing me?
Yep. 8 back. I used my sorcery points, converted it to a slot earlier. And then we got the short rest, I got him back, and I was able to do another conversion.
Okay. You guys make it through the storm, and you know, you're not really even, you know where the path is. You know, you've been on this path before, but your visibility is less than 30 feet, and you're just running along this path, and every now and then lightning strikes. Sometimes you can't even see each other. Just that driving rain and the hail and everything. And you barely make it. You just barely make it to the inn. And within, right around the Wayside Inn, it seems like the lightning and the hail and the rain and everything kind of stop, you know, almost the eye of the storm. Lights coming from the inn reveal a strange scene. Six humanoid creatures stand at the main doors, the same doors that the undead creatures were attacking the first time you guys saw the Wayside Inn in danger. The figures seem to be pounding on the doors, although they are hampered by the you know, some of the howling wind.
They look like armored guys, like we just fought.
Give me perception check, everybody.
Let me know. Can I go ahead and do my second win? Okay.
Is this a disadvantage?
No. No, Jin and Azure, you don't have to worry about disadvantage anymore. Okay. These are actually, let me get you over there. Boop, boop.
So DM, any objection that I use second wind?
Nope. I'm going to assume that you could do that.
Yeah, but for, short rest. It's an action, so yeah. Awesome.
Okay, let me get you guys in here. All right. So, can everybody see?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I can at least.
All right. So you see that these are commoners who are staked to the doors of and the wall, the outside wall here of the Wayside Inn, with tridents, and they're trying to like pull the tridents out, but they're not strong enough. They're all losing blood. But it, you know, you give me a religion check. Anybody who's proficient with that.
I am not.
All right, Fairvex and Azure, you can tell that this is part of a ritual. These people are intended to be offerings. Afterwards, after the ritual is complete, they will be sacrificed by removing the tridents. So they can remove the tridents, and then everyone who's stuck to the wall by a trident is going to bleed out.
But they're healed.
Mm-hmm.
How many dice of healing light do you have?
I've got one dice of healing light left. It's a long rest to recharge. However, don't we have a?
Don't you got a cantrip?
I got a scroll of cure mass wounds.
Cantrip. What's that?
I don't have it, but I think we've got a healer's kit. That should be enough to at least stabilize him.
Hold on.
I would say with the healer's kit, and either a dexterity or wisdom check, you might be able to pull out the trident and either stop the bleeding or pull out the trident in such a way that it doesn't bleed very much to begin with.
What's the cleric's? Does the cleric not have the cantrip that stabilizes?
I revivify. No, I don't have a first revivify. I did not.
Oh,
have
was
that.
It a spare the dying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like I do not.
Okay.
So these people are having seen you. Some of them even recognize you. You know, they're you know, maybe one of them is from Leyland, one of them is from Phandalin. People who are on the road who just recognize they see a cleric of somebody other than Talos, and they're super excited about that.
Finally, some fucking, you know, recognition.
Most of them have never seen a Duergar before. They don't know how to feel about that, but they're definitely they're reaching out. You know, help us, help us.
But so we have a healer's kit, yes.
Yeah.
I have a decent wisdom.
That healer's kit would give you advantage on the dex or medicine check, the sleight of hand or medicine check, to be able to remove the trident without killing the victim.
Like a Fairvax, how you feel about medicine?
I actually don't have either skill, but I've got a slightly better dex than I have a wisdom.
Okay,
so,
I'll take it then. I got medicine.
Okay, go for it.
And a wisdom. So, start from the end. You guys ready?
Yep.
Sure. I mean,
if it really goes wrong, I can basically throw a cure wounds.
Here we go. First one up. Fat.
Ooh. Nice. Nice. You're able to pull out the trident and immediately stop the bleeding on the victim there. You're gonna need one of your party mates to kind of tend to the wound.
I'd actually suggest go ahead and bring him into the stables. Only really one entry into the stables.
Well,
and it's hopefully
the door here, you guys know, goes to the stables.
Yeah, so I guess I need to unstake these guys all first. Yeah, I say go into the stable. There's only really one direction they could enter into the stables from.
Yeah, we don't know what's inside the stables.
Well, we know lightning's out here.
Okay. As soon as we unstake these guys.
I'm just saying, but that's my suggestion. I'm going to go ahead and do it another one.
All right. Sure.
Next one up.
All right, so we'll say this guy is down. All right.
I'll hang out with him.
This guy is down. And you go ahead and just kind of move him to the side. Give me an Arcana check, anybody who's proficient. Fairvex, as soon as he removes this victim from the door, you recognize a glyph of warding on the door.
Great.
Yeah, I warn him about that before it goes any further.
you know that the door itself, you know, just you could touch the door all you want, but as soon as that door opens, anything in a 20-foot radius is gonna take some damage.
Okay, let's get the rest of them down and away from the door, and then Azure, you said you could dispel?
Yep.
Yeah, if you still... How many spells you got left?
I have 3 third level, 1 second level.
All right.
Okay.
All right, you're working on this one?
Yeah.
Next. All right, she's moved off to the side.
And do we really recognize any of these people?
Not by name. I mean, you were never like friends or anything.
Well, that's the same token right there you used for that. What's her name? So it's like, hold up.
Oh, Tiga. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I was hoping you'd forget about that. I was like, damn, that's the same token. Oh well.
Okay, so it's just a token. It's not real. Okay.
Yeah.
Next.
It's not like anything assigned. Which one?
Let's do this one.
All right. You got him. He's off to the side now. Go ahead and give it to me.
Thank God you had that healer.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. Oh, no. The,
We gotta cure light wounds.
Do we have a potion?
I drank my potion.
Yeah, we've got a few of those, but...
Alright. So the, as soon as you pull the trident out, you're not able to stop the bleeding fast enough, and Fairvax is there as your backup to cure those wounds.
Okay, final one.
That person's actually feeling pretty good.
Yeah, yeah. That one's feeling better than everyone else.
Ooh.
Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Good thing I've got one more.
Oh, no. She's bleeding out. Oh, okay. Never mind. All right. So you're able to get all six of them off the door. And they even recognize, you know, that we didn't want to be part of the ritual. We wanted to get away. And so they're like looking around, looking at how horrible the weather is, you know, outside. This one right here, she kind of runs over to this bush right here and she says, hey, let's get everyone over here. And, move you, Jen. Let's get everyone over here. And she kind of, her and this one, that since they're the ones that got the cure light wounds, they're feeling pretty good. So they're gonna take care of the others.
Hey, Jen, can you jog over and check the other entrances? Rewards? Do you know what you're looking for?
I don't know what we're looking for.
Fairvax, can you explain what you're looking for?
You know, Fairvax, you could explain it, and then I would give Jin advantage on the Arcana check.
Okay. Do you want me to roll an Arcana to see how well I explain it?
Yeah.
Actually, the only other entrance I really care about right now, I guess, would be this one right here, and we can walk over there.
Yeah. Well, if this one's, I mean, we can dispel this one. I mean, I think going in.
But do I want to burn a third level spell for that?
Yeah, but they don't. If they think it's protected that way, then
we should have some surprise.
We should have some sort of surprise.
Okay, I'll do it.
All right, sweet.
Let's see.
I mean, it's base a third level spell, so.
Right. I wasn't sure what Glyph of Warding, what level it was. It's third level. All right. So the glyph ends on this door here.
Sweet. I'll pop up Pass Without Trace.
Is gonna scooch away from the door a little bit more. And Pass Without Trace, you guys are gonna sneak in.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
So I'll kind of slowly open the door to peer in.
Okay.
Do you want to stealth?
Hold on.
Alright. If only I had some boots of elvenkind.
Alright. So you open the door and you just kind of crack it. Go ahead and give me that stealth roll. Was it 10?
10. Sweet. 18.
Alright, let's... Yeah. All right. So your Pass Without Trace is definitely saving you there. You see some cult fanatics and some cultists walking around here in the courtyard where the stables are. And great.
And I noticed the other town folks.
Yeah, you hear them.
Okay.
You don't see them. They're actually thrown into the stables.
Gotcha.
And these guys are, you know, they're kind of whimpering, like, let us go, and the cultists are yelling at them, you know, shut up. And
so, the fireball that we have left is probably not a good idea.
It depends on where we position it.
Yeah. Can't we just burn this whole fucking place down?
Yeah, it is a stable with straw in.
Okay. I close door quietly and explain, wow, there's some people in there. What's the plan?
If only we had a lightning bolt.
No such luck here.
Oh, no. Wow. Yeah, that would...
I mean...
That would do the job.
We can... If you want to fire up... Well...
The problem is, I can't... I don't see them to exclude them from the spell.
Yeah, that makes it difficult. But then again, the spell shouldn't go through the wall, right?
Yeah, it's not going to go through the wall. They're in the stables. I don't know. I mean,
DM doesn't go through walls?
We can let the barbarian go smashing in through there and just... You know, there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... There was 6 of them in there. I mean, I've got 4 chances to stun. But I also have 15 hit points.
Yeah, I mean, is the wall of the stable stone or wood? I mean, the way it looks here is it looks like it might be a stone.
Yeah, the actual wall of it is a stone. It doesn't reach all the way to the ceiling. But the doors are wood.
So if I detonated a fireball right here, it would probably catch all the cultists but not hurt any of these people unless it blows out that wall.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean that's probably true.
Yeah. Probably. Let's open with that.
Okay. I like that. I like that.
Actually, real quick, who is still hurting hit point wise?
I'm 15. Oh, I'm sorry, 16 out of 53.
I'm going to throw an aid. So me, you, and Hammerbell all gain 5 hit points.
Oh, thanks.
All right.
It's not ideal, but you know what I'm trying to say?
Sure.
And I have a scroll of Cure Mass Wounds. Then we have potions also.
I mean, I'm down 15 from when I got hit by lightning, but I still have a potion that I can take. And one healing light left, so.
All right. I say we open with fireball.
Do it.
And Bell could rush in there.
Yeah.
Okay. Chuck in the fireball.
You want another stealthy roll to open the door?
Yeah. Who's going to be opening the door?
Well, we're all under the thing, but I'll crack it open nice and stealthy like I did last time.
Okay. Jin, as you open the door, you hear this cult fanatic. This one down here kind of walks up to this one and he says, "What's taking her so long? She should be done with this ritual by now. Why is Tiga doing it anyways?" And the other one says, "Because Bax is down in Leyland."
What?
And the Colfinet says, "Ah, oh, this is gonna take forever. Can we just kill them yet?"
Like, yes, yes we can. No.
Yeah, our bartender.
Bax is our guy. Great.
Uh, Oh, that was a crappy roll.
Ooh, what is that? That's
4 ones out of 8. Is there any, like, inspiration we can get for just having slogged through this stuff and just...
I would give him a disadvantage on the save, though.
I will say this. These guys don't have a chance. They are just splattered against this. You know, some nice and charred pieces of them go flying over, and you hear the townspeople over here just kind of. These two, let me put them near each other so I can have them do the save. That is a.
Would you give them disadvantage on the save for being surprised?
DC 15.
Because it was a 27 stealth roll.
Yeah. I mean, I'm gonna make this check with disadvantage. But. Save is half. Why is that not wanting to work again?
It could be. API scripts might not be. Something might have failed.
Yeah. Oh, that's fine. I'll just have him roll with. Where's that disadvantage? Disadvantage. This guy rolls his dex save. Ouch. So both of them take the full 19.
Get that extra little buff because of the Radiant Soul, whatever it's called.
I can boot. Because I didn't actually cast it, it doesn't get boosted.
Darn.
Yeah, it'd be nice if it did.
Was that our last fireball?
No, I still have... I think I still have 5 more of the beads. Yep. So.
Alrighty.
We can do some more serious damage if we need to.
Alright, so these guys, you know, as their lackeys are exploded around them and they take damage, they're definitely surprised. So everyone except for, if Bell and Azure, if you want to rush in.
Yep.
And Jin as well, if you guys want to rush in and try to take these guys out before they have a chance to react.
Definitely want to. Yeah. Raging as I go.
Do you want to waste a rage?
Do I?
I don't know. There's only 2 guys in there. How many rages do you have left?
3.
Oh, well, sure. Yeah, go ahead, then.
Go for it!
Alright. Go ahead and... Oh, yeah. I think that hits. Pretty sure that hits.
So, advantage because they don't know we're there yet or not?
Rage and reckless.
Yep.
All right. Well, since you can't use the spiked armor because you use your bonus action to rage. Sorry. But the other two did hit. So that is...
22. One is 14, the other one is...
You come in... Hold on. Hold on, Azure. You come in and cut this guy in half.
Oh, damn. Okay.
And then this guy, what is that, 8?
8, yeah.
You crunch in his shoulder, like his right shoulder, just kind of goes impossibly into his torso as you bring that hammer down. And he goes to the ground prone. Azure, you would have advantage on any attacks.
I would
have
hit anyway, but
yeah, you're
good. I guess I can see if I actually crit.
Yeah, and you finish him off.
It's kind of like that. Was I don't like that. That was easy.
But is the ritual still going on?
You do hear you do hear a ritual going on, and from these little windows, you see these guys over here, and they're just looking over like, holy shit.
Wave.
Hi, how you doing?
And,
Tiga? Oh.
I'm thinking, truthfully, if we don't see her there, I'm going to bet she's down the smithy because she's a smith.
Well, let's get in and free the people. Get them out to safety, or hopefully.
Well, we don't know what's in the smithy in the door.
Right. But let's get them out of the stables and, you know, either get them into another room that they can run freely from if they need to.
Take the 21.
So do you want to keep that 21?
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right. We got Azure, we got Jin, we got L, we got Fairvax. We go sort by descending. Oh, good. Mox came in at the bottom anyways. Alrighty. So, let's see here.
So these stairs here go up to a second level?
Yes, they go up.
Okay.
And you guys recall a long time ago staying here. Maybe not Bill, but everyone else recalls a long time ago staying here that there were two rooms that you could get to only by going up those stairs, and then the rest of the rooms you would get to by going up the stairs that are actually in the common room, the common area.
Unless Bell Kool-Aid Man through the wall.
Yeah. Yes. Very good point. All right, so Bell, what do you want to do?
Should we check the smithy?
You're gonna lose a rage if you don't attack something.
Yeah, I know.
Well, quick, run into the smithy and attack whatever's there.
Can you jump to the can you jump to the window?
Jump through the window. She will probably fit.
Yeah, you could try to Kool-Aid Man through the window.
You could smash the window.
Yeah, she could see him. This one, right?
Yeah. You could see him, and he does not look very pleased to see you.
She's mindless right now, so she's probably gonna keep and crash through and end up on that table.
All right, give me an athletics check with advantage.
Advantage athletics.
Ouch. Yeah, you are able to just smash through the window. Oh yeah, and go to town on this guy. So give me your attacks. All right. Pretty sure all those hit. Yes, all those hit.
Yes.
18 plus 14. 18 plus 14 is what?
32?
32. 32. Yeah. All right. All right. Yeah, he dies.
Sweet.
And everyone in the room is just like, what the hell is that thing?
She does yell, oh yeah, doesn't she?
That's up to Zen.
And Dwarven.
Yeah.
Dwarven. Yeah. How would you say, oh yeah, in Dwarven?
Who knows?
Yeah. All right. This cultist, let me have him make a save.
Piss himself?
I was going to say, after
pretty much. Yeah, he's gonna make a. What is it? What is that usually? A wisdom save? A will? Like a wisdom? Like a will save?
Will save.
Okay. Yeah, wisdom's usually for fear.
Hate that. Ogle, never whisper rolls. All right. Yeah, he runs into here, into the kitchen, behind the wall. This one
also fails as will save and charges at her.
This one rolled a natural one. He is going to run at you, crying.
With open arms.
And try to attack you with his scimitar with disadvantage. 14 does not hit, correct?
No.
Okay. This fanatic. Kool-Aid man will save.
He's fanatical.
Yeah, he fails. He's gonna run into here, into the kitchen. And leave his buddy out there alone with Bell.
So do we want to try taking one of these up alive? Ask him about Bax.
Yeah, I plan on wrapping out of Bax. I will swing the doors open and motion for people to come this way.
Oh, the village people?
Yes. YMCA.
YMCA. They definitely don't look the same as the others, I promise.
No, they've got a 90-degree rotation on them, so of course they look different.
Yeah, yeah. If you squint your eyes and look at them sideways, sure. Okay, Jen, that is your turn.
Yep.
Fairvax.
Well, we kind of need to see what's going on in the smithy, so... I'll poke my head in, check that door for, if there's glyphs or anything like that involved there.
You do not see any glyphs in the smithy.
Okay.
Or on the door to the smithy, and opening up the door, you see that the fires are hot. As if somebody had been using them. However, nobody is in the smithy.
Dang it. Okay. In which case, double back, say no one's in there, and hopefully they're upstairs.
Azure.
Actually, double move.
Can I do a nodulism check to see if they're doing a ritual where they would more likely be at?
What makes say more- again?
Can I do a Naudrillism check to see if they're doing a ritual where they would... Does it need to be a wide open area? Does it need to be...
On the roof.
Yeah, on the roof. Or can I do a Naudrillism check for that?
It's going to be pretty high, but go ahead.
My religion sucks.
Don't let Morden hear you say that.
Morden heard that, yeah.
Fuck! You heard that, but not when I'm getting fucking electrocuted.
Yeah, I got nothing.
All right.
So, Fairvax, you think upstairs?
Yeah, I think upstairs.
Fuck. Let's go.
Go for it. Go run it up there.
3, 4, 5. That's my 30 foot right there.
Jack could do a full move.
I'll do a dash.
Where are you taking him? Where are you going to sweep his little icon off to?
Can you
put two different maps next to each other?
Yeah,
Yeah, these are just two different maps next to each other. Yeah. All right, Azure, do you see where you're at?
Yeah, and I'm doing a dash.
Give me a perception check.
You know nothing.
This about pretty much in line with my character. Oh, fuck. This is gonna hurt.
There's what's her name?
Oh, I was more worried about
All right. So, as you run up the stairs, you don't even notice as Valine Firecrow is here on the roof, right above where you guys were just standing. Makes a light crossbow attack. Hits you and does. I'll actually roll a 4d6 rather than let it just say 14. Of course, I got 14. All right.
So here's the fun little thing with this, though. The trigger for shield is whenever I take damage or we're attacking.
Right, right. So you could.
Reaction.
Yeah. So you could totally use shield to protect yourself from this.
I'm going to need to.
All right.
Alrighty.
Wait.
So you don't.
Did you have any more first level or you got to cast at a higher level?
I got to cast a higher.
Oh, ouch. That's, you know, it's okay. It's worth soaking 22 points.
Exactly. Consider I'm at 37. Yes.
Yeah. Is it dark? Is it dim light?
It is starting to get, yeah. I would say in here it's dim light. Yeah. Not only is the sun a little bit lower by the time you guys actually get there, but it is, you're surrounded by these very dark storm clouds. All right. Mox?
Let's see. Probably gonna just stay near there and ready in action to assist.
Okay. Bell.
Keep an eye on the thief that just shot at Azure, actually.
Bell takes one swipe at that one. Is he standing?
Oh, well, yeah. You cut him in half.
And give chase.
To these guys?
Uh-huh.
All right. So you're going to go ahead and move down there. Do you have enough movement for that?
Let me see. Is she at 35?
Oh, yeah. There you are.
And doing a hammer.
On which one?
I would go for this guy.
Okay.
Red, whatever. The fanatic?
Yeah, the fanatic.
That's at 18.
All right. You smack him. He hits the wall, but he's still standing.
Yeah.
That also hits. You give him a nice big hug, and he is full of holes and not happy. Very, you're starting to see the life drain from his face. It goes very pale. The cultist is going to try and.
Ooh.
Yeah, I didn't even mean to do that.
Initiative.
I was just changing his stupid disadvantage off. Does 16 hit you?
Yes.
He should be having an advantage anyway.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah. All right. Well, there. All right. So you took whatever half of 5 slashing damage. 2.
2.
All right, this fanatic. It's going to cast Hold Person. Go ahead and give me a Wisdom saving throw.
Bill?
Yes. Yeah. Oh, no.
That is a minus one.
So he's like, stop hitting me. And you're like, no. Jin.
All right. Can I do some acrobatic something to shorten this? It doesn't really matter.
So you want to jump up here?
Yeah, I can use movement to get down to there and then up there if I have to. But
I mean,
is there anything to?
All depends on what you want to do.
So I'll give him a little bit more information real quick. I am at the top of the stairs. I'm not through the door yet. So technically, I should be right there at the top of the stairs. Still, you should be able to see me. I'm not sure if that changes your perspective or not.
Yeah, so he's here pretty much.
Yeah,
up the stairs. That's okay. I can 25, 40. Mm. So I'm at the top of the stairs, and I still have 15.
Did you see where the bolt came from before it makes that move?
Say again?
Did he see where that bolt came from before he makes that move?
Yeah. So
I was down stairs, so probably not.
Yeah, it's.
Oh.
I mean, you know that it came from above here.
Yeah, that's how I wanted to kind of mention before you actually up the stairs.
I don't understand. So I can see the roof top of these.
Yeah, from up here, you can see the rooftop. Technically, you're here.
Yeah, put me where I'm at. Okay. So, yeah. So is she visible?
She is right now. Well, actually, hold on. Hide. Make a perception check.
do I have to match it?
Yeah, you're going to have to match it. But it's the first one, 15.
All right, then I'm using my little clockworky thing to auto roll a 10. So I've got plus 5 on perception, so I'll auto 15.
Oh, okay. Then yes, you can see her.
All right. So I will port over to her with a bonus action. Pink.
You know, I think she should have taken fireball damage. I'm just saying.
And
she was above
20 feet?
Yeah, it's 20 feet.
If the villagers didn't, then she didn't.
Oh, okay.
And all right, so that's a move. That's a bonus action. Here's an attack. Bink.
That's a hit.
She can take 7, and she can make a roll for a stun.
Is that a con
DC
save?
DC 13 con, yeah.
Oof.
All right, second attack.
With advantage now, right?
Yep.
Yep. That's a mess.
Sweet. Okay, well, she's done. That's useful. That's all I got.
And that's until the end of your next turn, right?
Yes.
Okay. All right, Fairvex.
Okay, I will join them upstairs.
Alrighty. I'll go ahead and move you over here.
All right. So I assume I get to... Oh, okay, they're on that roof. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, they're on this roof. This is the ground, and gotcha. These stairs lead up.
Okay, in which case, now that I can see Jen attacking her, I'll throw a pair of Eldritch Blasts that way.
Okay, you get advantage. All right, both of those hit. Anything other than 18?
Nope, that's it.
Okay. All right, both of those blasts hit the lean fire crow. And you could just see, like, her hood falls off, her bright red hair. It just kind of flashes around as she gets, you know, kind of falls down on the roof. And still stunned, unable to keep herself from sliding off. And she hits the ground. She takes the damage.
Isn't it supposed to be a d6?
It was a small fall.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah. Is it a d6? What is it, d6 every 10 feet?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right. Fine. Ooh. There's your extra 5.
Worth it.
What have we learned? Always argue with the GM.
Not necessarily argue. Just...
Hey, I'm always about
reason
fairness.
With.
I'm always I'm always about fairness, especially when Jim wants to remind me that that Doc needs to concentrate on Fly.
Yeah.
All right, Azure.
3, 4, 5 foot right there.
Yep.
And yeah, I'm going to enjoy this. Booming blade spell.
Prone and stunned. You're going to get advantage.
Yep.
Until the start of your next turn. So they don't actually take the booming damage.
They do. Higher level.
Yeah, they take damage on the attack, and then there's the extra damage when if they move.
Yeah, the spell...
That's just so waiting.
At fifth level, your melee attack deals an extra 1d8 thunder damage to the target.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. All right, so that's a total of 21?
Mm-hmm.
Ouch. Anything else?
Yeah, I'm going to finish my move and actually just go ahead and take a... back up a little bit.
All right. Anything for Mox? I'm just going to keep you guys over here for the purpose of...
That makes sense. Yeah.
So Mox is here.
Okay. Well, since she's a familiar, I don't think she's allowed to attack. Otherwise, I'd have her stab her. But,
8 other. That doesn't really make a difference because disadvantage in a way.
She'll stay out of reach for now and keep an eye out for anybody else that might be hiding.
All right. Belle.
Belle. Continue attacking on. Oops. This one?
All right. It's a hit. Pretty sure.
Ending.
Yeah.
Down. Turn. And yeah. The other two on the other person.
Yeah, that hits.
Man, Bell.
So you come through. You come through with the great axe, and just chop this dude in half. Your great axe sticks into the wall. With the force it takes to pull him out of the wall, you spin around and hit this guy with the hammer and smash his skull, and it just pops like a balloon.
Having way too much fun in there. No, it kind of scares me.
And you see the blood. You see the blood start dripping around, just all over the place.
Okay, she will at least move to look for her friends.
She'll stroll over to the bar and chug a tank and inhale before.
You could run up the stairs, see if there's anything upstairs.
Well, she can only move like halfway through the, room right now. Mm-hmm. That's my job.
Belle, give me a perception check. What's your passive perception as well?
Nice, Dirk.
Passive is 12.
All right, passive is 12. Give me a perception check.
Oops, sorry. 20.
As you're admiring your handiwork and you see the blood, I'm going to move you back down here.
Okay.
And you see the blood everywhere. You see that some of the blood is dripping, it's made it all the way over here. The half of this guy that was here just kind of like fell and rolled. And his blood, and you can see it dripping into the edges of this trap door.
Oh. Great. She will move to investigate later. But she will move.
All right. We'll keep that in mind for next turn. The trap door is wooden, and let's see here. If it says anything about it. Nope, it doesn't appear to be locked.
Mm-hmm.
So next turn you can do something about that. This Master Thief is still stunned until the end of your next turn.
I will jump down and whack her.
All right, whack, whack, whack.
24, 19, and 19.
That all hits.
All right. Points.
Said 19 total?
Yeah.
All right. You're just beating her up. She's on the ground. You're curb stomping her. Fairvex. She's looking pretty rough.
Okay.
But she's not stunned anymore.
All right. No advantage then?
No.
Okay.
If you have the high ground.
She is still prone. So on melee strikes, you would have advantage.
My question is,
I could fly over there and hit her with a shillelagh, green flame blade.
You could certainly try.
Yeah, we could do that.
All right, so you gargoyle your way down there, and that's a hit. You want to do it with advantage just to see if you get crit?
Oh, sure. I just roll it again. Nope.
All right, the 21 hits.
So the shillelagh does 5, and the green flame blade does. Hold on, let me double check how that's supposed to work. Okay, so. It's before additional fire, plus 3 for Radiant Soul. The 13 would be if there was another enemy next to her.
All right, and Shillelagh is like a staff, right?
Yeah, it's basically a cudgel. All
right, so you just fly and as you land, you just bring this thing into the torso of Valine Firecrow, and. And the flame, the green flames expand from where you strike in and just keep expanding until she's you know, ashes and dust.
Great.
It looks pretty cool.
Except for those cool magic items she was wearing.
Oh, those survive.
Okay.
All right. Anything else?
I think that's all I got right now.
All right, Azure.
I yell for Hammerbell, ask how she's doing as I come back up these stairs.
Hammerbell, I will give you a moment to respond.
Can she actually hear?
Yeah. Because he's pretty much by this window where you created a hole.
Doing fine, but there's something interesting in here, in the kitchen.
I just kind of stop there.
All right. Max.
Oh, hold on. I meant to think. I'm not going up the stairs all the way. I'm going to go ahead and go through the hole she made. That's a better lead than guessing it upstairs, is what I'm trying to get at. So I stopped going upstairs. But 5, right. 10, 15 yeah, right Mox there, will... roughly.
Yeah, Mox would poke her head in upstairs, following behind Azure.
I didn't go upstairs. I'm downstairs.
Yeah, Azure's not going upstairs. He went. Oh, okay. He went through the window. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, is the door upstairs at the top of the stairs open or closed?
It is closed, but it is not locked.
Okay. I don't know. So I don't think she'd be able to open it. So.
I mean,
I'm going upstairs.
I don't think Mox wouldn't. I mean, I think Mox should be able to open a door.
Okay.
Use a lot of its movement, you know.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, open up the door and basically hide. Ooh, that was an awful roll.
All right. As,
unless we still have pass without trace by being near Jin, in which case it'd be decent.
Yeah. It's within 30 feet.
So. Mox pokes her head in and... doesn't really see anything. There's a bedroom here and a bedroom here.
Okay.
See if there's actually... Oh, yeah, I guess I do need to actually move the dynamic lighting. Boop. I gotta zoom in so much just to move the stupid door. All right, there.
Okay. Unfortunately, I can't see what line of sight Mox has.
Oh. Meh.
Have to see if there's a way around that another time.
Yeah.
Because I think we're...
Yeah, look at that. Look at the time.
I wasn't going to say anything because I don't want to stop.
Yeah.
Well, agreed. I mean, we really want to take care of a taiga, but, you know.
I mean, you guys want to see if next week Webley can make his way through the lightning storm to get to you guys and help you out?
I don't know why he would.
He might have a party with Thistle. And what else?
All right. So if you guys want, I could throw in another 20 minutes if everyone's down. If not, I don't want to pressure anybody into more time.
I'm good.
No, I'm good.
I think we're okay.
Okay. All right. Continuing on.
All right, Hammerbell, what you doing?
Oh, I yanked the door open.
All right. And... You yank the door open, and there is a landing and then a set of stairs, and that's all you could see for the moment. Unless you're without going in.
She will go in.
Oh, yeah.
She's reckless right now, right?
All right.
Since she didn't attack anything, she's out of rage.
Yeah,
you'll have to rage again, but you got like two more.
Two more, yeah.
So do you see yourself?
Yep.
All right. Crates, barrels, and other containers holding food and drink have been pushed aside to make room for a large copper statue at the far side of the room. Just pretend this is copper.
Mm-hmm.
The statue depicts a four-armed storm god holding lightning bolts in each hand. Before the statue stands Tiga, the blacksmith. Actually, we're going to swap these two because that is the token I used for Tiga last time. Before the statue stands Tiga, the blacksmith. In the corner behind the statue, Marticia Vinetalker, the owner of the inn, is bound with rope. Her face is bruised and bloodied, but she bears no mortal wounds. Tiga stands proudly before the statue.
Okay, that's not a... Great. Definitely...
Great, kick the crap out of her.
Yeah. She will waste another rage.
I don't know what your movement... I don't know how much movement you use.
Let me see. How much did you move from there? Let me see.
We'll say it was 10 foot of movement down.
Yeah, and she could... No, she could... She should be able... Down 15? 20? 15?
Yeah.
15.
So you could make... So your whole 35 movement is here.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, because you went 5 just to get into the... Because, like, 5 to move over here, and then 10 to go down, because you went down.
Okay, so she should be able to have one. Can't rage, but she could spike her. If she... dash. No?
Yes,
because the bonus attack, yeah.
Yeah.
You can't rage, but you can spike.
Yeah. Forget the rage. She's gonna rush her.
Sweet. Oh, but you're not. But you're not.
Oh no, 19. Yeah. Dang.
Let's see, Tiga.
It's just not rage, so it's 12.
What is Tiga?
Tiga. Well, it's not a crit either, so it's 9.
Oh, yeah, 9. Hope she gets stuck.
All right. Let's see. All right, so 19 plus... wait, how much damage here?
19 to hit, 9 points of damage.
Minus 9. Yeah. All right, it did hit, and she definitely takes some damage here. Belle, you see that now that you're closer, you see that lightning is flowing between the statue and Tiga.
Mm. So, what does it do to Belle?
Nothing.
All right. Is that it?
Yeah, that's all Belle could do.
Add her to the initiative roll. And... One other thing. See that the statue begins to move.
Uh-oh.
Luckily, you have the cleric coming.
Statue. Make sure I know here.
But the sacrifice was saved.
The statue is going to move down, smash some barrels out of the way, and headbutt you. Well, that's not nice. Take off the stupid always roll advantage. Is that hit?
No.
And then... Ten.
Yeah. Oh!
Two of those hit.
Another 19.
Luckily, you got a cleric coming.
Holy.
All right.
Is he done?
He is done. He is done. He is done. Jen.
Fuck.
All right.
I mean, the thing has four arms.
I'm sticking to what I would think I would do. Cleric goes into the thing. I'm going to run up and see if there's people upstairs. So I'm not dicking around. I'm just kicking down doors.
All right. I'm not even going to mess with it. In both of these shared bedrooms, you see no one.
Okay. I've got... So I'm going to assume with 110 movement, I can check that out and get back down or pick it to the stairs and say, nobody up here.
Yep.
All right.
Fairvax.
Okay. If we know that nobody's up there, then I guess I'm going to follow Azure and Hammerbell through the common room.
Okay.
To where they went.
I see here. Put you... So here's where you are. Go ahead and make your movement. There's a big hole in the wall here.
L 2, 4. So double move will get me to here. So dashing.
Oh, there you are.
And all right. I think that's it.
Okay, this is Tiga. Tika gets a +5 to hit. For some reason, the thing that Tika isn't in the stupid. All right, so that definitely misses. Is there, nope. Oh, she goes reckless. Jesus. Tika has this just warped look on her face as she just like kind of rages out a little bit and tries to swipe at you, Belle. However, very unsuccessful. Azure.
Okay, so I'm going to move my 30 feet down. And I assume I see the trapdoor, right?
Yes, and you see that it's open and you hear sounds of battle.
I yell in the kitchen this way. And I take my basically a dash action. So I go down. As soon as my wife would stop coughing up a lung.
Okay.
Alright. You can make it to here.
What's this back here?
Oh, that's Marticia Vine Talker.
Okay, gotcha.
A prisoner. Okay. Must
be. Now I'm going to what is Tiga wearing?
Tiga is wearing she is wearing hide armor.
Any places
kind
or
of,
anything?
It's outfitted, you know, it's kind of very, it's almost more ceremonial than, you know, something. You think under other circumstances she would have been wearing like full plate, something that she
made
herself.
Yeah, that's what I was expecting. Okay, fuck. The other question I have is curiosity. Do you? It's a brass statue.
Mm-hmm.
Is a.
Stone statue.
No,
copper. It is
copper.
Yeah.
So, would heat metal affect it?
I would think. I would argue for yes.
I mean, yeah.
I think it would heat it up so it'd do more damage to Bell when it slammed.
Yeah.
But yeah. Still disadvantage to its attack.
Yeah.
Because it took damage.
Yeah, maybe.
I would say.
I mean, if it's made of metal and magically metal.
Would it take does it take fire damage? Is it
sure
resistant to fire damage?
You know, it's not wearing it. It's not. I don't know.
Yeah. Choose a manufactured metal object. This is a metal weapon or suit of heavy or medium metal armor.
It's still a manufactured metal object.
Any creature in physical contact with the object takes 2d8 fire damage. This isn't a creature, this is a construct.
So you're not going to allow it?
I think you just make it stronger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because Bell will take
it. Yeah. I would say that you would just make it glow red hot but it's still it's not like you're doing anything to the metal other than heating it up. It's not going to take damage or anything.
I don't think if it's not immune to fire damage, you think it would take damage too, but okay. In that case, I'm just going to action surge it. So I got my extra action. Now throw up the blender.
All right. Let's see here.
I got it.
Keep in mind.
You guys are up there.
We're up here. We'll figure that out real soon whenever we come running into
the. Problem is, like.
Yeah, because you have to see us when you cast it, right?
Yeah. It's going to be a real pain in the ass whenever I'm invisible in darkness.
You can designate any number of creatures you can see to be unaffected by it.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's fine. Pop it up. I don't care.
Pop it further out, though. Can you?
It's on. It's centered on me.
It's always around him.
Yeah, dang it.
Hey, my idea was the heat metal. I was proud of that one.
Yeah, that would have been a good one.
But of course, the blacksmith isn't wearing metal, and the giant metal statue is immune to it. So it's like...
Just popped your bubble.
But that is my.
Well, at least lightning shit is not lightning damage. At least it's just slashing damage. So once you rage, you're going to be taking half.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go.
All right. Enters or starts his turn there. All right. Mox.
Mox is going to fly down from here. Basically down and in to the kitchen.
All right. Mox is there.
Yeah, I made a wrong turn.
You might not want to go reckless, Zen, because you're going to get advantage on what's your face anyway, and you don't want that guy hitting you.
Yeah.
Hammer Bell.
Bell will attack the statue.
Rage.
Yes, rage. Definitely.
Okay. So go ahead and attack the statue.
Not that. 18?
18 hits.
The 10 missed, right?
Yeah, 10 missed. Sorry, I didn't see that one.
12.
Okay. All right. And that's So that's it for you, right?
Yeah.
Statue
is
going to headbutt you.
After a will save.
So that's 15 damage,
yep,
right?
15.
Headbutt misses.
All right, headbutt misses.
Oh, I ate 3 hits.
Bubbly's missing a damn good battle.
She takes 15.
Yep, 15.
Yikes.
Hurry up, guys.
Alright, that's his turn. Jin?
Alright, I can... 15... 20, at 20 movement, I'm in the room, so you want to scooch me over to inside the room. That's 20. That's 55. There's the trap door. So run me down. I've got another 55 to go. Where's the trap door?
Right here.
Okay. So
you go there. That's another 10.
I've got 45 more to go.
That's another 10 just to get here.
20.
I would stop. Go ahead and stop.
Go ahead and do what now?
Stop.
If I see the angel things, then I'm stopping.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. So you're gonna stay at the top.
Oh. Okay, if I can see angel things, I'm stopping.
Yeah, you open up the trap door and you see at the bottom there, you see the blender going on and you're like, crap.
Okay, then, yeah, that's what I got.
All right, Fairvex.
I'll get down there as well and stop as well. Stop before entering the blender.
Whoa, blender.
Yeah. Yeah.
That takes like
a dash
from you, right? Yeah.
Yep. So I wasn't going to be doing much anyway. Yeah. Now, from looking down the trap door, like, how far down is it before you can actually see? You know, is it like a 10-foot? Or is it like open, you know, how is it?
It's 10 feet down to a small landing.
Okay. So it's like a 10-foot tunnel.
Yeah.
Okay. So we wouldn't be able to see anything from up above. Other than
right,
just,
yeah.
Like, the,
yeah.
The
you can't target anything
stuff down
for sure.
At the very bottom. Okay.
Yeah. All you see is like the blender happening.
Gotcha.
All right,
blender.
Tiga.
Blender.
Woohoo!
Ouch.
That's odd.
Just place stuff on my, you know, on my nice, beautiful spikes.
All right, so Tiga takes a lot of damage from the guardians, and she goes to move in. And the guardian just smacks her in the face, and she kind of, exactly, she just falls right into you. And you just lower that shoulder and thrust her back, and she takes a couple of damage. Go ahead and give me a spike damage, Bell.
Yeah. Oh, no rage. Oh, yes, rage. 10.
All right. So you shoulder some spikes into her, and she just falls down here. She's flat on her ass. Bleeding pretty bad. Azure.
Okay. Can I squeeze through here? Do right there?
Yeah.
Can I do that? So that's 5. 10.
Uh-huh.
And 15. Dodge action. Actually, I'm going to dodge action and continue to move a little bit more. 20.
I'm guessing you designated
her.
Yeah,
I did see her, so yeah.
Yeah.
I'm basically going to check on her and moving the spirit blender because I heard the monk upstairs.
Hey, move that spirit blender shit.
Pretty much, I heard the monk. Whoa! Shit.
Whoa.
And I did the dodge action.
All right.
All right.
All right, Mox.
Okay. She doesn't dare go down under there either, so there's not much we can do with the blender going.
Bill.
Hold on.
Bill will continue assault on the
Her
statue.
I did it on her.
Oh, you want me to kill her?
Yeah. If you kill the source of magic. Plus, right now,
if she's reckless, you got advantage on her.
Yeah, that's true. I'll try one swipe with the hit.
That does not. Wait, who are you attacking? Her or the statue?
Her. It was her.
Oh, yeah, that hits.
Okay. I'll give her 15.
Okay. She's still up.
Okay, one more. 15 hit?
15 does hit.
Another 18.
So you see Tiga stumble back and land on this barrel at that hit with the great hammer. And she's just bleeding all over the place. And she just kind of like sits down next to the barrel and bleeds out and just stares blankly.
And the statue is still animated.
The statue is still animated, and there is still lightning between the statue and Tiga.
Oh. Interesting.
Okay.
Well, I still have a spike on the... Why not? On the statue. 19?
That hits.
10 on the statue.
All right. Statue's turn. Blender. He's going to...
Damage from this guardian.
All right, he needs to make his will save.
Oh, right,
the
sorry.
Blender. Sucks at these will saves.
13. I don't get it. Like dueling is literally unchecked, and it still puts it up there.
That is weird. All right, he gets a headbutt and 4 blade attacks.
Oof! Headbutt and hits.
He only hits with
two lightnings hit.
Ouch! 31. 15. So 15.
15 more. She's still stunning.
Great. I look down. Do I see the blender?
You do not.
I will jump down and hopefully move to where I can see shit. Great. Can I sneak past Hammerbell?
She's tiny.
And get there.
Yes. Watch out for the spikes.
Alright. Then if I get to there, still attack him.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. So he probably. Oh, I don't get advantage, sorry. Burst 22.
Yeah, 22 hits.
I'm gonna try to stun it. What the hell? I don't know if does it even look like it has a chance?
To be stunned?
Yep. I mean, I try it.
Yeah, no.
Okay. Bonk. All right, well, then I will continue. Second attack. Sweet. So, 9-11 there. Or 12 there. And I will burn a key and be defensive. That's what I got.
All right. Fairvax.
All right. If it's clear, I drop down there as well. Okay.
There you are.
And then I'm going to move. And once I've got line of sight at the statue, I'm going to fire Guiding Bolt.
Where's that luck point?
Yeah, no kidding. Wow, that hurt.
Guiding Bolt. Guiding Bolt. Oh, what's the normal damage on Guiding Bolt?
Normally it's 46, but I cast it at third level, so it's 66.
Ouch. Give me 2d6.
Okay. Come on. Why is it? There you go.
5.
All right. You take 5 radiant damage as Guiding Bolt just like explodes in your hands.
Nice.
Yeah, not really. Not cool.
Now, you see Tiga over here, and despite how much
radiant.
Oh, dang.
Despite how much blood she lost. Oh, yeah, I take half damage from radiant.
Oh, nice.
And also, she needs to save herself from the spirit.
Yeah. She can pop in and out all day long.
She steps up. She steps up and as you see the flesh start tearing from her face as the ancient guardians just keep clawing at her. She stands up and she's realized that her body is out of blood. But you can still see the connection between her and the statue. And she looks down at her own entrails, and then looks upward to you know, you're sure that she sees something, and she just starts continuing on this ritual, just shouting to the Storm Lord, and the room darkens.
Noise involved.
Say again.
There's noise involved.
Okay. Yes.
All right. But she took damage from the radiant, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And you can see it as her condition seems to deteriorate.
Okay.
Azure.
Well, I look towards the bar owner. Is she bleeding? Is she hurt in any way?
She's a little bruised, but other than that, I mean, she's fine. You know, she's like looking up at you and just kill that thing, get it the hell out of my bar.
I'm gonna take another step this way.
Trying.
Oh, that gets. Is she still in there or not? They wouldn't do that.
Is what in there?
Are you still in it? About half her square.
The blender?
Yeah.
The blender, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I had her make a save for the blender.
No, I mean, I just moved. She's moved. Still in it.
Is she physically in
it? Oh, okay, okay. Yeah.
15?
I'm gonna say she's kind of leaning up against this thing now. She's kind of...
Okay, we'll remain here then.
Cause you could...
Yeah, you're fine. Stay where you are.
And I will actually do my Dwarven Thrower and throw it. At... I only got it. Yeah. I don't like her chanting. I'm going to throw it at her. I can't take off her head or something.
I would go for this.
If she's the one that's keeping it running, hopefully that's the right choice.
All right, I had advantage all right. on.
13 still hits.
Okay.
Yeah, yep. The dwarven thrower knocks her into the corner, and she shuts up for a moment. And do you call the dwarven thrower back to your hand?
Yep, instantly. Then
does it look like we're chipping away at the denting up the statue?
Is the statue taking damage at all?
It is. You're chipping away at it.
That's it.
All right. Do you even want Mox down here? You just want me to take Mox out of the turn order?
Yeah, let's keep Mox out of that area for now.
All right. Belle.
She'll keep guard up top.
I don't know. Maybe Reckless is doing it now.
Yeah. But she'll go down the next time he attacked.
Well, maybe you might want to be Reckless then.
Yes. Sure, why not? Reckless it is. Okay.
Hit. Where's your three crits?
I lost it.
All right, the first two hit.
Okay.
That is a total of
25, sorry.
Mm-hmm. 25.
All right. You're able to start smashing this thing. You know, part of its kneecap comes off when you hit it with the hammer, and then you know, you're chopping into it with that axe as well. Now it's its turn, and you went Reckless, right?
Yeah.
It's
just going down, you know. Well, there's 8.
I mean, that's okay. Got 10 left. Apparently, there's a cleric on the way still, so we're still good. Wait, that was me? Shit.
Alright. Where are you at now?
10. Oh, right now, another 4. 9.
Let's see, that's...
Yes, 9 left.
Eight.
You got this. Where's that pass heal? Where's that pass heal?
Miss.
Oh, that one misses.
A hit. 5 more. Right.
Are you still up?
4.
Got 4 left.
Nice. All right. That was 4, right?
That
was,
no.
Can we say yes?
Oh, that was only 3. That
can
was only
we
3.
Say yes?
Oh gosh.
Oh. 3.
You, you have 1 hit point.
Uh-huh.
Still standing.
Jin.
Alright. Whack, whack, whack.
Wait, sound like a duck.
Wait, do I wanna this lady's chanting, right? I don't really wanna fuck up our spells, but I could silence this place. But that's going to mess up Fairfax. I'll just hit it. So that's a miss. I clicked that, didn't I? Second attack is a miss.
Oh, wait. Statue never took the radiant damage from my Spirit Guardians.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Do a radiant. Do a Spirit Guardian.
No, sorry. I didn't mean to roll its advantage, but saves.
Oh, that's fine. Took 2 damage, never mind. Wow.
There's 7. And I'm going to burn a key and do a... It's not gonna. I'm gonna kind of try to hit him again. There's another 5.
All right. He's still up, but he's definitely looking worse for wear. Fairvex.
All right. Let's hope I don't critically fail on this again. Guiding bolt.
That's a miss. Anything else?
One healing light on Hammerbell. Wow, that was awful too.
Well.
All right, Bell, you get 2 hit points.
Thank you.
Tiga stands up again, rearranges her jaw, and
makes a will save.
15 points.
And these guardians just kind of shove her back into that hole. It's a little too much damage for her. And so there's no reason why a living person would be able to do this, except for the fact that she's still connected to the statue.
Right.
Azure.
I'm going to do the Dwarven Thrower towards the statue this time.
All right.
Nice.
Wow.
Is that total?
Yeah.
That's
nice.
5, 27. All right. So, what would Azure say to declare Moradin's superiority to Talos? what would be like a cry of just religious fire?
I'm open to some divine inspiration for my party. What do you guys think?
I don't know. I don't know. Talos. I don't know. I'm trying to rhyme with Talos.
My first come to mind, I was like, lightning bolt this bitch.
There you go. Yeah, that's good.
The falling mountain is more thunderous than you.
Nice.
I mean, that would make sense, but not nearly as fun.
Yeah,
I'm just fucking tired of being shocked and lightning bolted and everything else. It's just like
lightning bolt this. Yeah.
And once, so it's one of the things. Once again, I'm pretty sure the blacksmith just won. what did I tell him? The kid. There was
okay.
One that was doing the
The
prayers to Talos. It's like the prayer may stop the lightning, but the I guarantee the weapons or something like that along those lines. The same thing I told the kid.
All right, so you shatter this thing all over the floor, and Tiga makes one final cry to the heavens and to Talos, but she can't even finish his name as she gargles dryly on just the sand that is now her lifeblood and falls over dead.
Great. Yay.
And so you have vanquished the threat. You can already see from this passage here that the warm afternoon light coming down just through the where the trapdoor is.
Nice.
Which means that the storm clouds are no longer overhead. And that is where we were going to call it today.
We get ready.
Damn good session.
Great. Yay.
All right. We will start next session with Webley and Anders and Thistle rolling up, you know, like, oh man, you guys stopped it. Right,
so that's... So, remember when the barge would tell this...
next session with that.
Remember when the barge would tell this tale?
We'll have Webley roleplay how appreciative he is that you guys went and handled this threat for him.
Yeah.
Like, so I'm just saying, when the barge would tell this tale, make sure they note that Webley was not with us.
Yeah, that's the key. All right, take care.
Good night,
I'm
guys.
Waiting. Very good.